furnace, right? Now, when we come into animals, are animals autotrophs or heterotrophs? Will they prepare food on their own or will they depend on someone for food? Yes, they depend on someone for food. They can't prepare their own food. They either eat the other animals or they eat the green plants. So that's why they are called as heterotrophic. Okay? Now let us see. Animals can't prepare their own food. See, they depend on someone. Deer is eating grass and lion is eating that deer. The tiger is eating. So they're heterotrophic nutrients. Even non-green plants are also heterotrophs. Now let us see. See, these are fungi, okay? They depend on the other plants for their food. See, this is the host. Which is different, they are, that is called as host. These are called as parasites. Now, these are some kind of plants which eat animals. This is pitcher plant. What does this pitcher plant do? If suppose an insect comes and if it sits in that particular thing, immediately the slits get closed and they eat that insect. Okay, these are called as insectivorous plants. Understood? They modify themselves in such a way that they can eat well. Now, mushrooms are another example which they feed on the dead substances. They provide, they supply digestive enzymes. They release these digestive juices which digest all this food and in the, if they get in the form of nutrition, they consume and they grow. Okay? Now, fungi, bacteria use this, okay? I'm sorry. Yeah. These are called as saprophytes. Understood? Yes.